Hi and welcome back. So in this video we continue our first inspection of our Titanic data set. So in the last video we print out our whole data set. However, with a large data set with many rows, it doesn't make sense to print the whole data set. And in the most cases, to get a very first good impression, it's enough to have a look at the first five rows and the last five rows, for example. And therefore, there are two very helpful methods here. So first of all, we have the head method, and let's press Shift Tab here. So the head method returns the first n rows of our data frame, and by default, the parameter n is set to 5. But yeah, we can change it. But now, for the time being, let's try it here with the default parameter. And we can see here now our very first five rows of our data frame. And we can pass different values to our parameter n. So, for example, if you want to have a look at the first 10 rows, we can set n to 10. And then we get the first 10 rows. If it's enough to get only the first two rows, then we can pass 2. So now we know the very first rows and in combination with the very last rows of our data frame. So this typically gives us a very good overview over the data set. And we can call the very last rows with the tail method. So by default, the tail method returns the last n rows, and n is set by default to 5, but we can change also this here. And let's say we want to have the last 10 rows. Then here we got the last 10 rows. And you can see here within the head method and also the tail method, we can see here the column labels, and we can also explicitly call our column labels with the attribute columns. And here we get a so-called index object, so it looks like a list with all the column labels. So survived, P class, sex, age, zip SP, parch, fair, embarked, and deck. And we can also explicitly call our row labels here on the left side with the attribute dot index. And here we can see that we have a so-called range index, so starting from 0 until 891, and 891 excluding. So here we started with 0 until 890, and this is a so-called range index. And there's a very helpful method called info where we can get metadata on our data frame. So let's try this one here. So dot info. And here we get meta information on our data frame. So if, for example, here you can see that it's a data frame and that we have a range index with 891 entries from 0 to 890. And we see that we have in total 9 columns. And here we have the labels of the columns, so survived, passenger class, until deck. And here we can see the amount of null values. So typically in a data set, there are missing values or so-called null values. And here we get the information how many non-missing values we have. So here in the survived passenger class and sex column, we do not have any missing values. So we have values for each row. And for the age column here, we have obviously 177 missing values. So for 177 passengers, we actually do not know the age. And in the deck column, there are obviously many missing values. And here on the right side, you can see the data type in each column. So in the survived column, we have either 0 or 1, it's an integer. And also in the passenger class column, we have 1, 2, or 3, this is also an integer. Then in the sex column, we have object. And in very easy words, object stands for a string data type. And then we have age, which is a float, so for example, 33.0 years. And in the zip SP and parch columns, we have an integer, so the amount of siblings or parents. And in the fare column, again, we have a float, so the price for the ticket that the passenger paid, for example, here 7.89. And embarked and deck, these are both columns with string objects actually here, so you can see S and B. And then here you can see a summary of the data types. So we have two columns with float objects, we have four columns with integers, and we have three columns with strings. And the total memory usage of our data frame is 62.7 kilobytes. So we have here a very small data set actually. So there are data sets with megabytes and gigabytes. So this is very small and easy to handle. And there's also a attribute called shape. So this does not actually give us more information, but it gives us the shape of our data frame. We have 891 rows and 9 columns. And last but not least, there is the very helpful method describe. Dot describe. And here we can see for all numerical columns, so we have here integer and float, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 numerical columns. We can see here a summary for each columns, and yeah, actually summary statistics. So count stands for the amount of non-null values. And in the survived column, we have 891 non-null values. So these are actually here the same values as here. And we can see here in the age column that we have missing values. Then next here we have the mean for all columns. And we can see here that in total 38% of all passengers only survived. So 62% died in the Titanic disaster. And the average passenger class is 2.3, so there are much more passengers in class 2 and 3 than in class 1. And the average age is 29. And the average ticket price was 32. Then we have here the standard deviation for all columns and the minimum. So we can see here the youngest passenger was 0.42 years old, actually a baby. And there were passengers that died. So the minimum value is 0, 0 for died and 1 for survived. And with the passenger classes 1, 2, 3, the minimum is 1 here. And we had actually passengers that didn't pay anything for their ticket. And then here we have the 25th percentile, we have the 5th percentile, which is actually the median. And we have the 75th percentile, and we have the maximum for each column. So there are passengers who survived. The last passenger class is class 3. The oldest passenger on board was 80 years old. And there was a passenger that had 8 siblings and spouses aboard. And there was a passenger with 6 children or parents on board of the Titanic. And the highest fare that was paid was $512 or pound, so obviously a passenger in class 1. So now we are finished with the first inspection of our data set, and only after a few minutes and a few lines of code, we actually know a lot of information about our data set here. And in the next sessions, we further build on our skills to further analyze our data set here. So hope to see you there. Bye.